Nobody here but us chickens.
I found the Christmas tree.
Oh, that is very festive.
Well, I certainly should have bought a new one.
That'd be all right when you unroll all the stuff on it.
Yeah, well, there's only the one left. All the rest were broken.
That is lovely. That is lovely. You can hear those sleigh bells, can't you? Christmas, what a load of old wank. Oh.
Come on now, Mr. Carter. You didn't really think that.
Yes, I do. It's a load of hypocrisy. A 48-hour ceasefire from hating each other while we stop to commemorate some stupid myth. God, it makes me so...
Here! Let's do presents!
Oh, come on, let's do presents!
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Well, that's another bit of excitement over for another year, isn't it? God, Christmas Eve. Why do we always have to work on Christmas Eve?
Yeah, I know, I mean, Christmas Eve, you know, I mean, I miss watching my kids opening the presents in the morning. I wanted to see the faces.
Why, what have you bought them?
Easter eggs. Oh, I mean, they're in the shops now, aren't they? They're cheap. Well, mind you, I say Easter eggs, you know. I got a bit hungry yesterday dinner time, you know, and, well, when I came to wrap them, you know, there was only half an egg left. So what I did, I got this big clump of cotton wool and I dyed it yellow, right? And then I made two little legs out of matchsticks and I painted a couple of eyes and a mouth on it, you know. So, well, it looked like a baby chicken. And then I sellotaped it to the other half of the egg what was left. And then I, you know, wrapped it in this... Oh, no, that's right. No, I'd run out of wrapping paper. So I rammed it down the end of this empty Weetabix packet. So that's what they're getting for Christmas.
Well, there will be some happy little faces in the Bell household this Christmas, won't we, Sarge?
Yeah, they like a surprise.
Yes, they're going to get one.
And what have they bought you, Mr. Bell?
Don't know. They usually write me a cheque.
Ah, there you are, lads, now. The season of goodwill to all men, eh, lads? You don't mean that, lads, do you? Look, come on, we're here. We might as well make the best of it. Come on, let's have our carols.
Oh, carols. What do you think? You know, what's the point? No, it's the same every year. Nobody ever bothers to turn up to listen.
Yeah, look at all the invitations we sent out. We did not get one reply.
No, all those people, right? Harold Pinter, the Pope.
Yeah, you think at least the Pope might have turned
up. He could have spared 2 minutes of his time, couldn't he? Yeah. I mean, God, I'd have given my right arm to kiss the papal ring.
Right, probably busy.
Busy? It's Christmas Eve, for God's sake. What else has he got to do?
No one's going to turn up.
Come on, lads. It's Christmas Eve. Come on. Let's start a bit.
No.
Hey. Number one. Right. You ready?
Yeah, yeah.
A one, a two, a three. It's the Pope. It's an unexpected papal visit. Perhaps it's Harold.
Harold? Harold Pinter? Harold wouldn't knock like that. That wasn't a playwright's knock. That had the Vatican written all over it. Ding dong.
Please, I'm going to have a baby.
Is the Pope pregnant?
No.
So who was it then?
Well, just some stupid woman.
The Pope. All right, anybody can make a mistake.
Never mind. Perhaps Harold will turn up later. He's probably working, finishing a new screenplay.
Yeah, he might have gone to a hog roast.
Yes, yes, he's gone to a hog roast and he'll probably pop in on his way back.
He's Jewish, though.
Who?
Harold Pinter. I mean, what's the point of him going to a hog roast if he doesn't eat pork?
How should I know? It was Harold's idea. He was the one that wanted to go.
Well, they were going to wait for him or not?
No, no, let's carry on. We can always recap when he turns up.
Hmm. One, two, three.
We three kings of Orient are.
One in a taxi.
One in a car.
One on a scooter, sounding his hooter.
Following yonder star.
Well, yeah, you see, now we're getting into the spirit of it. Right, come on now. Number two, eh?
One, two, three.
God rest ye Jerry, mental men, let nothing you dismay.
I'm sorry to put a damper on things, but this is not a favourite of mine.
Well, let's try another one then.
Number four, let's do that one. Let's get good that one. Oh, one, right. Two, three.
Well, shepherds wash their socks by night, all seated round the tub. The angel of the Lord came down and gave them all a scrub.
Fear not the deep or mighty dread that sees their trouble now. That tidings of great joy I bring to
please,
you.
Please, I'm going to have a baby!
For 1, 2, 3,
ding dong, merrily on high. When the bells are ringing, ding dong, bell in the sky. When the bells are ringing, Hosanna in excelsis.
There you are, miss. Drink this. Plenty of sugar. That's what you need in your condition.
Oh, sorry. I was just looking at your slacks.
I got them from Mother Care.
They're lovely.
Thanks.
What's your name, miss?
Mary.
Drink your coffee, get out.
Excuse me, miss. Mr. Carter, there's no call for that.
Sarge, it's Christmas Eve, right? We have a pregnant woman, right? Called Mary, right? Ring a bell? Well, what we have here is an allegory.
What, you mean like the prodigal son?
No, that's a parable. A parable is something which uses familiar events to express religious and ethical situations, whereas
an allegory is a situation in which the apparent meaning of the characters and events is used to symbolise the moral and spiritual meanings. I think that's what you're trying to say, isn't it, Carter? Yes.
Yeah, exactly, yes, Ding Dong, yes. So,
I know what you're thinking. It's not an allegory.
Oh, yeah, really? Says who? And you wouldn't have a husband beginning with J, would you?
It's Carlos. His name was Carlos.
Was? You said his name was Carlos?
Dead. 2 months ago. Where he was doing this sponsored walk across the Sahara Desert, and he tripped and fell into an oasis. Drowned.
Well, it happens.
There's no one else I can turn to.
Well, why don't you go to a hospital? I mean, that's the proper place for you.
No, I can't, because I've got this morbid fear of sheets.
Oh,
look, I can't go to hospital. I'll have to have my baby here. I've got money. 50 gold sovereigns.
Oh.
It's Christmas Eve. I'm pregnant. There's no one else I can turn to. You're my only hope. If I don't have my baby here, I'll have to have it outside in the cold, in the snow. It might die. Oh, please. Please help me.
Sovereigns, you said.
Something's starting.
Right, but you did say 50 gold sovereigns, right?
Come along now, Mary. You'll be all right. 50 gold sovereigns, you said.
Yeah. Anybody there?
Listen, just sign that, will you?
Oh, what is it?
It's just a standard contract saying that you will not be doing anything of an allegoric nature. Oh. There you go.
Hey there, Mary.
Something's happening, I can feel it!
Oh, some waters! Our waters are going to break, that's what it'll be! Mr. Carter, Mr. Bell, come on!
You wouldn't listen, would you?
Oh, no, you had to stand there, go up and...
God, I'm nervous.
I know.
How do you know?
What?
You said I know. How do you know? I'm nervous.
No, man, I'm nervous.
You're nervous?
Yeah. Why aren't you?
Oh, I see. So I'm not allowed to be nervous because you don't want to be nervous. Is that it, right?
No, I'm going to be nervous anyway.
Yes, and me. God, what time is it?
8 o'clock.
8 o'clock? Oh. It's going to be a long night, isn't it?
What time is it now?
10 past 8.
It's coming!
Hey!
Hey! It's coming!
It's coming?
Yes, it's coming.
And what would its coming be referring to, Sarge? Not the late arrival of a number 9 bus?
It couldn't possibly be referring to the birth of a child, could he?
I wouldn't have thought so, no.
Quite. I'm sorry, I didn't realise. I wasn't thinking. What should I say, then?
Do we have to do everything for you? Improvise!
Try something a little less prosaic than it's coming, honestly.
Oh, right. Like Mercury on winged feet!
Better!
Like Mercury on winged feet, I come with news of nature's greatest miracle. As ripened apple from the bough doth fall, so Mary, that maid most fair, hath in the 9th month of her confinement seen fit on us her most bounteous gift to bestow.
What?
It's coming.
Oh, really?
That's it, Mary. Push. Good girl. Nearly there. You two should have a look at this, you know.
No, it's all right. So you go first, girl.
I'd rather not if you...
No, go on. You have a look. It's all right.
Very nice.
No, I'm not.
I'm ashamed to miss out, you know.
Oh, yes, don't spoil the party.
A 1, 2, 3. He's always doing that, don't worry. There's nothing to it, really, is there? I mean, I can't miss that.
Ticket, Mary, yeah, go on. One more push. Go on, Gary, go on. Oh, well done.
Well, is it a girl or a boy?
It's,
Well, is it a girl or a boy?
Well, I'm not sure.
Well, I suppose, if you look on the bright side, you know, it's not all bad, is it? I mean, well, it looks healthy, doesn't it?
Yeah, if you look on the bright side, I mean, if you look on the bright side, she's not going to have to teach it how to swim, is she? Oh, Christ.
What have you got there?
Oh, Mary. Mary hasn't quite finished yet.
Twins!
Mary is a very determined young lady. She says she's gonna keep going until she has a proper one. A baby, that is. I tried to reason with her, but she won't listen.
This can't be doing her any good, can it? I mean, poor girl, I'm going to put a stop to this.
You? What do you know about it? You haven't got any kids. You don't even know where to put it.
Oh, you're an expert, are you? Huh? A moron has 3 kids and suddenly is Dr. Spock.
At least you've been there, mate.
Shut up! Right, that's it. I'm going to sort her out. I've had enough of this. No, I'm going to be firm. Hello? Only me. Mind if I...
No, be my guest.
Thank you.
What's the matter?
No, it's all right, it doesn't matter.
No,
I don't want to... Read that. I wrote this play, right? I sent it off and... I mean, I don't want to be a security guard all my life, you know. I've got plans, see? Yes, plans. And that's what they wrote back.
Dear Mr. Captor.
Yeah. I know, it's incredible. They can't even spell my name right.
Therefore, we are returning your script.
That's it. And that's it. That's all they wrote. People can be so insensitive, can't they?
What's it about your play?
Do you want to read it?
No. Honestly,
no, really?
I couldn't.
I'm not one of those people, please, who are precious about their scripts. Oh. You know, I mean, if you'd like to read it, Go on.
Scene 1, Hampton Court.
Yeah.
A little man.
A little man, yeah.
Walks up to a bigger man.
Bigger man. Really? Yeah, well, it would be more impressive, wouldn't it? Yeah, if it was.
Little man, I hear the king is to dine with us tonight.
No, sorry, actually, Mary, sorry. I hear the king is to dine with us tonight.
I hear the king.
No, actually, I hear the king is to dine with us tonight.
I hear the king.
No, but sorry.
No.
I hear the king.
Look, don't think we could do this later.
All right, forget it.
It doesn't matter.
God, people can be so insensitive. They don't give a damn. Well, I can't get any sense out of that girl at all. Poor girl, you've got to be firm with her, got to be straight with her.
Oh, yeah, I used to go wrestling all the time. Mick McManus, Jackie Ballow, The Mask, Jack Barr, yes, I saw them all. Greetings, grapple fans.
Could you
tell you what I did see. I saw the masked Mexican once.
Oh, yes?
Yeah, dead good he was. Big fat bloke. He was jumping up and down this bloke for ages, you know. Mind you, I had to give up going to wrestling after that.
Oh, why?
Well, I went out in a car park once, you know, get his autograph.
What, the mask?
The masked Mexican, yeah, Mexican. Yeah. And, you know, he didn't have his mask or his costume on him out, and he was just, wearing these trousers and a sky blue leisure shirt, you know. Yeah. I reckon I wouldn't be too far out if it was saying it was some sort of toweling material, but, the thing is, he did not look like the masked Mexican. And the Argonauts!
What's this?
What this is?
The Great Escape! Oh. They're always showing that.
Oh, Gernandine! Hey, firm, eh? Straight to the point, eh? Oh, honestly, you two, you haven't got a clue. Here, let me have a try.
Yeah, Sarge will sort it out.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh! Hey, lads! Oh, look!
My turn. I've had nothing since the microwave.
I'll swap you for the leather Chesterfield and the Sabutio.
No, the leather Chesterfield is not the Sarge's style. You'd prefer the matching hand luggage, wouldn't you, Sarge?
You wouldn't think God would let such a thing happen, would you?
God! There is no God! I keep telling you that. God's not going to help this! Sarge?
Yeah? What are you doing?
Sarge, get up. Get up, you look ridiculous. It's embarrassing.
It's Christmas. It's time for miracles.
You tosser. Here, I'll swat you at my bike and Vitelli for your picture of those houses in the water.
Houses in the water? That's one of Canaletto's views of Venice. I'm not swapping that for a mountain bike.
Oh, look, a little boy.
Here, he's got your eyes. Both of them.
What are you going to call it, Mary?
I'm going to call it... Jesus.
Hey, you said...
Yes, it was an allegory all along and you fell for it.
But you signed a contract.
Look at the signature.
Harold Pinter. You dirty... What's Harold going to say about this?
I don't care. I wanted to do an allegory and now I've done one.
Yes.
Get back! Oh.
Where'd you get that?
Oh.
Where do you think?
The Allegro.
No, the allegory. Allegory. This allegory, what's it all about?
Oh, come on, are you stupid? It's all about how we've lost sight of the real meaning of Christmas, how every year we drown under an ever-increasing pile of consumer goods.
Really, it's not very original, is it?
No. Well, I never said it was. But it worked like a dream, though, didn't it? And I just bet you had a little serious moment between the three of you, didn't you? Well, didn't you?
Yeah, well, the Sarge, he...
What? What did he do?
Well,
what? No, don't tell me. He came out with some stupid moral, said that Christmas is a time for children, something like that?
No, actually, he prayed.
Oh, brilliant. Better than I could have hoped for.
did you kneel?
All right, now, you've had your bit of fun. Get out.
Oh, don't worry. I'm going.
Where?
To see my husband.
Carlos?
No. His name is Joseph. And we came to pay our taxes. Goodbye, suckers.
We thought she wanted help. And all she wanted was an allegory. What's the world coming to?
I feel such a fool.
I know.
How do you know I feel a fool?
No, I mean, I feel a fool as well. No. But... hey.
It's Harold Pinter! It's Harold! He's got the Pope with him!
What are they going to do?
The way I look at it, there's only one thing we can do.
And a partridge in a pear tree.
Good night, Your Holiness.
Good night, Mr. Pinter. Mind how you go on that tandem.
Dad! Look, Sarge. It's snowing.
It's Christmas, Dad.
For unto us a child is born. Christmas. A time for playwrights. A time for pontiffs. A time for all mankind. Christmas. A time for carol singers. A time for children. A time for the old. Christmas. A time to forget our cares and worries. And rejoice in the birth of our Savior. Christmas, the season of goodwill to all men. Merry Christmas.
That's the night we met. There was magic abroad in the air, and like an echo far away, a nightingale sang in Berkeley Square. I may be wrong, but I'm perfectly willing to swear.